Good morning.
Good morning.
I'd like to welcome you on this Sunday, on this last Sunday in our Pride Month, and also celebration of our ONA covenant. Glad that you are here, whether you're in person or watching online. Glad that you're with us today, and hope it is a meaningful service. And I'm also glad, pray for me, because I forgot my microphone, and so I'm hoping I'm not going to forget anything else today. So if we bypass something in the bulletin, just raise your hand and say, Butch, come on. All right, so glad you're here today. Have a few prayer requests to share with you this morning.
Prayers for the friends and family of Dave Dagger, who died suddenly this past week. Dave was a friend of Rich Hartman, and prayers for his family, and prayers for all the friends and those who knew him, especially with such a sudden death. We also continue our prayers for Bill Walk, who is at the healthcare center at the Lutheran Community, prayers for him as he recovers, and also prayers for Dave Reef as he's dealing with a recovery after foot surgery, and just prayers for him and also for Carol. We also ask for prayers for our country, especially after the recent Supreme Court decisions, and for all the people who are affected, and especially for women, and for all that, what that means, and knowing that it's going to lead to, I'm pretty sure, more and more crisis, and I would hope conversation, but unfortunately it also sometimes leads to more divisiveness. So let us pray for our country in the midst of this and what may come in the future. Those are all of the prayer requests that I have to offer today, so please remember these today and as we pray about them as well a little bit later. And let us now prepare our hearts and our minds and our souls for worship. For those who are able, please stand for the call to worship. We come today celebrating the majesty of creation.
Diverse and beautiful, blessed and beloved, all made in the image of the Creator of all things.
We come today called to this time and this place by an infinite God.
He hears our cries and responds with love.
We come today seeking the presence of Christ and the guidance of the Spirit.
We come today knowing you will inspire us to show us your Spirit.
We come today knowing you care for us.
We come today knowing that you have been protect us. Your arms are open wide to cover and help us.
Come, let us worship God with full and open hearts.
Thank you.
God, show us your ways and give us the courage to choose the harder paths you lay before us in our walk as your disciples. As we seek ways to live out your justice and mercy, help us to truly see our need for you and your Spirit. Help us to remember the grace that sustains us. Give us your courage and your strength, O God. Mold us into the people you want us to become. Amen. Will you pray with me the prayer of confession as printed in your bulletin? We give thanks, merciful God, that in Christ you seek to unite all things in heaven and in earth, and to reconcile all people to one another and to you. We confess that the new creation is not yet complete in us, and that we feel everywhere the barriers that separate humankind. Too often we wander from the path of love upon which we are meant to walk. Fears divide us, prejudice hardens us, violence destroys us. Forgive us and fill us with your Spirit of oneness. Reveal to us those places where pride and selfishness rebuild the walls once torn down in Christ. To the power of your Spirit we pray. God promises to all who trust in Christ forgiveness of sins and fullness of grace. And eternal life in the kingdom of God, which has no end. In Christ Jesus, you are forgiven.
Gather this day in the grace of God and the peace of Christ. And so I say to you, the peace of Christ be with you. Now let us share Christ's peace with one another.
Doing this morning? Yeah, a little shy. Yeah. So, does anybody know what we're celebrating today in church? Hasn't been said yet, I don't think. And we did say it? Okay. No, it's okay. It's all right. So, I'll give you a hint. It's represented by this little flag. It's all right. Today is Pride Month, and today is Pride Sunday. And we're celebrating the diversity. This flag represents the diversity of all people. So we got LGBT folks, people who have different genders, people who are black, brown, and others. And so we want to celebrate all of God's people because God loved us. We're called to love everybody else. And this flag even though it's for the LGBT communities and for other people, it also is a reminder to us that we are to love everybody regardless of their status in life. So just every time you see this flag, I hope you remember that and to pray that we would love others well. Will you pray with me? Holy One, thank you for this Pride Sunday and for this chance to remember that you love every single person regardless of gender, sexuality, color of their skin, socioeconomic status, mental and other disabilities. Help us to break down those barriers and to love you and others well. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you all for joining me.
Our epistle lesson this morning comes from the book of Romans, starting in the 8th chapter and the 31st verse. Hear these words. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are counted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. May God add a blessing to the hearing and reading of these words.
Join the family of God. Everyone's welcome. No matter who or what you are, walk through these doors without fear. Come, join the family of God. Don't hide or feel ashamed. Your God does not make mistakes. In her heart, we're all the same. Cause we are affirming church. We love and accept all who seek. Laid for gender diversity, for justice and equality. Gender diversity, for justice and equality.
Thank you, Rich, and please thank your brother as well. That was a beautiful song. Our gospel lesson this morning is found in the gospel according to Mark in the 9th chapter and beginning with the 38th verse. John said to him, "Teacher, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us." But Jesus said, "Do not stop him, for no one who does a deed of power in my name will be able soon afterward to speak evil of me. Whoever is not against us is for us. For truly I tell you, whoever gives you a cup of water to drink because you bear the name of Christ will by no means lose the reward." And may God add a blessing to the reading and hearing of God's holy word.
Good morning, Zwingli United Church of Christ. My name is Kevin McLemore. I am the Associate Conference Minister for Search and Call in the Pennsylvania Southeast Conference of our United Church of Christ. I am not the Reverend Bill Worley, our conference minister. He is actually on a much needed sabbatical this summer. But on behalf of the conference and our churches, I bring you greetings and congratulations on becoming an open and affirming congregation, I think just recently. There is something to be said about opening the door wide, about being clear about who is welcome in a world in which many of us don't know whether we are welcome in particular spaces, especially church spaces. Your willingness to say, "We are that space. We believe the gospel is for all and that all are welcomed," is a good thing. And I congratulate you on making that very clear to yourself, to the community around you, to people like me who always are looking for spaces that can both challenge us and yet welcome us wherever we happen to be. So again, on behalf of the United Church of Christ and all the 4,900 churches, and especially the 153 churches of this conference, I bring you congratulations and God's blessing on this good moment.
Amen is right. I am deeply grateful for the message from Reverend McLemore, the Associate Conference Minister, and deeply grateful that we are indeed an open and affirming church, especially this day as we come to the last Sunday in the celebration of Pride Month. Now, what we've been celebrating this month is a lot of different things. One is to commemorate the Stonewall riots. And even though we may not want to necessarily commemorate a riot, these were riots that started a watershed movement towards LGBT rights and liberation. It's an important date, an important mark, and something to be remembered, something to be thought about, something to be celebrated. But this month is also a time to honor and lift up the contributions and the lives of LGBTQ plus folk, for the contributions made to society, to also celebrate this month and also hopefully in the months and years ahead, inclusion and diversity, equality and freedom, and the dignity of all people. This is also a month to bear witness to a radical welcome of all people, and not only again this month, but also hopefully in the months and years ahead. What I love about our ONA covenant, which we will read together a little later in the service, is that it echoes these themes of welcome and affirmation, inclusion, diversity, and dignity. And our covenant grounds all of these things, all of these wonderful values, all of these wonderful things that we are called to be and to do, grounds all of this, sees as its very core, at the very foundation of all of this, is a central aspect of our faith, which tells us, as Pastor Allen said so clearly in the children's message, that God's love is for us all. Not just for them over there, not just for that church down the road, not just for this group of people, but for all people. And today we are here to celebrate that especially. Well, the passage from Romans speaks clearly about God's love and how there is nothing. I don't know if you heard those words, if you were really listening to those words, but it says that there is nothing that can separate us from God's love in Christ Jesus. And this is the same Jesus who included folk that others wanted to exclude. This is the same Jesus who told those to cast the first stone if you yourself are without blemish. This is the same Jesus who appeared first to women after the resurrection, and how women became the first evangelists, the first to tell the good news of Jesus' resurrection. This is the same Jesus who treated tax collectors, those hated tax collectors, and treated those who are sometimes just referred to as sinners, but treated them with dignity and hospitality and grace and healing. Oh, to be such a church, to follow in the way of Jesus. But as we gather this day, we know that there are those who are opposed to these values. And even though they may say that they also appreciate these values in action, we find that they are opposed to these values. We know that there are those who get caught up too much in exclusion about who's in and who's out and who belongs here and who gets this kind of right and who gets denied these rights. We know that there are people who get too caught up in control, whether it be of women's bodies and lives, or whether it be of black and brown bodies and lives, or whether they seek control through the misuse of power or fail to understand Jesus's wide embrace. There are also others who don't understand these values of love and dignity and inclusion, who would rather harm and kill, and who focus on idols like money or guns, or who are motivated by hate and discrimination. As we gather here today, I know that all of us get exhausted by having to deal again and again with the hate and with the misunderstandings, with the hurt, with the prejudice, with the power of privilege, and so many things that make us feel tired and wondering how we can overcome. But what I love about our scripture today is it's told us, or it tells us, that we have already overcome. For those who follow in the way of our Savior, we have already been surrounded and immersed in the love of God that is beyond all understanding, a love that sustains us, a love that strengthens us, a love that helps us to serve and to welcome and to affirm. A love that helps us to create a safe space in this divided world where people, LGBTQ, brown and black siblings, those who suffer addictions or soul injury, all are welcome here and are to be shown the love of God. As it says at the end of the song that Rich just said, you can find love inside these doors. This is the church we want to be, isn't it? Well, the biblical scholar N.T. Wright says that too often, though, we fail to see the truth of the gospel. And the truth of the gospel has something to do with our identity. Too often, we think that, you know, that old saying that says, I think, therefore I am. So our identity is found in our thoughts. Or we might even say that because I'm comfortable economically, therefore I am. Or we turn to something like, I've achieved this thing or that, therefore I am. Or I'm part of this group that's better than this group, therefore I am. But N.T. Wright points out that the central message of this Roman passage and of the gospel and of the Bible is that I am loved, therefore I am. Our identity is found in that reality, and it is this love of God that is a part of all of what we do and who we are and who we are called to be. It is a love that calls out and reaches out beyond the despair that people might have. It's a love that doesn't avoid suffering or hurt or that despair, but that reaches over and above and beyond, a love that we can find within, a love that leads to us living our deepest humanity, God's deepest grace, and leads us to live in the way of Christ. All of this love, talk about love and inclusion and diversity and all of these things, takes me back to a story I've told once before that reminds me of an experience of God's love that was stronger than the hate I expressed when I was in college. It was during my junior year, I think, and I was taking a class in Jungian thought.
focusing on the writings and wisdom of the psychoanalyst Carl Jung. We wrote reflection papers each week based on our readings, and on one week we were reading some thoughts that Carl Jung had about homosexuality. And so in my reflection paper, I said that gay and lesbian people deserve to be reviled, deserve the hate and the judgment of good Christian people. But the professor, someone I admired and respected and who taught me so much, gently and with care asked me to consider alternatives, to reconsider my rigid attitudes. A professor who treated me with kindness and mercy when he could have just as easily taken me down a few pegs and given me a grade more appropriate in light of the hate that I had expressed. Then, a few months later, I found out that this professor was gay. You see, I had told him that he had deserved hate and being excluded. Yet he responded in love and care. Something inside of me broke because my exclusive, hateful, judgmental attitudes and words and beliefs had been met squarely with the love of God. Those words and feelings had been met with mercy and grace. They had been met with kindness and a gentle nudge, not a bang over the head, but a gentle nudge to think and study and research and pray. And 42 years later, I am still learning. It's a journey that doesn't end with a few things that we agree about or a covenant that we make. It is a lifelong journey to learn about the depth of God's love. 42 years later, I am still trying to be as good a Christian as that professor was in that moment, in that day. His actions remind me of so many who have toiled in the muck and mire, armed only with the love of God, a love that God has for all people. And it is that same love that gives us our truest identity. It is the same love we are called to share. As we think about this day and as we think about the week coming up, I invite you to review our bulletin again and again, because the prayers and the songs and the hymns emphasize over and over the central theme of our faith, that God's love is supreme and is with us in all times and moments, even when we face the worst that the world can give. It is a love that spurs us to acts of mercy and kindness. It is a love that helps us to work for justice, equality, and forgiveness and healing. It is a love that is to become a part of who we are. It is a love that I hope people feel when they come through these doors. The hymns and the prayers remind us that these are not just words, but are attitudes of the heart that nurture the way of love that God has given to us as a gift. As I was looking through these hymns and songs, I didn't know what to pick, but I thought that this one song from the songbook that we had a little trouble singing, but had these great words, I think really says it very succinctly. That goodness is stronger than evil. Amen. Love is stronger than hate. Amen. Light is stronger than darkness. Amen. Life is stronger than death. Amen. Victory is ours. Victory is ours through Him who loved us. May we who have faith in God and a God of love continue to bear bold witness to that love, not only in Pride Month, but throughout our lives, for we have been called. We have been touched by the light and life and love of Christ, and we have been sent to be God's servants in the world. May we embrace our call with courage and with strength and with plenty of love to share. Amen.
Will you remain standing with me and join me in the affirmation of faith? At Zwingli United Church of Christ, we promise to engage and nurture Christ's light in all of God's people, no matter their sexual orientation or gender identity, race or ethnic background, social status, soul injury, religious beliefs, age, and physical, mental, or addiction challenges. We aspire to be a counterweight to exclusion and discrimination. We choose to purposefully welcome and include all people in every aspect of our church family, including worship, fellowship, and leadership, lay and ordained, and we'll meet you where you are on life's journey to share God's love with you. Our commitment is that all members feel and be safe as we express God's universal and unconditional love in our church, community, and daily lives. O Holy One, thank you that you come and fill all of our life. We thank you for the reminder of your love that found us and that we are to turn around and give out to others as you remind us that we are to love everyone, even our enemies, every person regardless of gender, race, sexuality, skin color, mental health, every single person. Help us to love more and help us to love better through your love for us. We think this morning of those who are dealing with life's troubles, and we want to lift them up to you this morning. We think of the family and friends of Dave Dagger, especially Rich, who is friends with him. We just pray that they would find comfort and peace as they mourn, that they would grieve well the loss, sudden loss of Dave.
We pray that you would heal. We're thankful that Bill is in recovery and that he is recovering. We pray for continued health for him.
And for Dave, as he recovers from foot surgery, we pray that you would give the doctors wisdom as they continue to treat him. And we think, too, this morning of all of the hurt and turmoil that's happening in our country right now over the Supreme Court rulings this week. We pray that you would heal our nation. Help those in control and power to move towards justice, not towards trying to control and coerce people into doing things. We pray for those who fear for their safety as the implications of this decision impact other aspects of life and other aspects of who people are and how they live and who they love. We pray that you would put a stop to that. Oh, Holy One. We lift all these things and place them in your capable hands. We pray them in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and power and glory forever and ever. Amen. And it looks like we have a stewardship moment. Is that you? All right, come on up.
The stewardship special emphasis this year is from bread and cup to faith and giving. What are we passionate about as a congregation? What are we invested in with people, our talents, and our money? The UCC vision is united in Christ's love, a just world for all. To get there, we as a congregation must act to be united in spirit and be inspired by God's grace. Welcome all, love all, and seek justice for all. We need to be faithful stewards, use the resources God provides, and give as an expression of gratitude for all that we have received from a loving God. How is the world being transformed by our presence as a congregation? We pray together each Wednesday at noon on Zoom. We seek God on Sunday mornings at our worship service as we gather together in community, share our joys and sorrows together, and sing together. We use our offerings to help and serve others. At this time, we invite you to give your offerings in the offering plate if you are here, bring them to the church, send them in, or give through the website. I know it's summertime, but just because it's summertime doesn't mean the missions of our church do not need our help. They continue to go on and need our help. Let us pray. God of openness and affirmation, we dedicate these gifts to the ministry of love and acceptance in the world. May we ever seek to use our resources to create a world and a church where all are welcomed and honored, loved and fully known. This we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Charlotte. I have a couple of announcements to share with you, and the first one will be from the missioners, and there will be it's going to be played in just a moment. I do want to warn some people that there's some disturbing images, and so just wanted to let you know that. So, please, if you could play the.
On 9/11 that morning, it was chaos. I remember when I first got there, and I've never had a feeling like that before, and it was evil. It affected all your senses. You could smell death.
Another plane just hit. Right, oh my God, another plane has just hit. It hit another building.
A huge explosion now, raining debris on all of us. We better get out of the way.
I hope I live. I hope I live. It's coming down on me.
I would encourage people to come and see the exhibit just to get a feel through the images and the artifacts of the World Trade Center. And like I tell so many kids today, 9/11 is still here, it's every day.
Not everybody has the time or resources to take a trip to New York City. It's a wonderful way to come and get a sample of what happened down there and to learn about the Silla Foundation.
visit the mobile exhibit because there's so much to learn here about September 11, 2001. I donate my time to the exhibit because I believe in what the foundation is doing. Never forget.
So I also draw your attention to page 14, the Tunnel to Towers mobile exhibit and the connection with Miller Keystone and their hopes to collect 343 units of blood, one for every New York firefighter who made the ultimate sacrifice on September 11th. So please, if you can be a part of that, please do so. I also want to draw your attention to page 13 and the church picnic and the service at Perkasie Park. That'll be on July 10th. Just a reminder that that service on July 10th will be at 10:30, and you're also asked to sign up on the bulletin board if you'd like to bring something along. I know that food will be provided and served, but there's also some other food that that we hope that you will bring along to share with others. So please be sure to sign up on the bulletin board for that. I also invite you to take a look at all the other announcements and explanations and the many different things that are in our bulletin about the community that we are a part of, about the faith that we share, and about the things that are coming up for you to be a part of. So please, please pay attention to those. Take some time to read through those whenever you're able to do so. And so now let us come to the conclusion of our worship as we sing together songbook number 107.